to get into certain neighborhoods because of either safety issues or just the inability to sample in certain locales. So it's very important to really understand what population is necessary and what population are we talking about that needs to deliberate in order for us to really understand what the people are thinking about a certain issue. And if a population is really difficult to get, what are alternatives? Can we try something online, or can we separate out groups that will make it easier to sample? Following, the next decision really is the mode of recruiting, face-to-face versus phone versus online. We've done all three, and in some cases, we've done two modes in one project, or three, and it all depends on the amount of time, resources, and access, and ability of all the organizers to get together to make it happen. The next slide is who will do the recruiting? And this question is sometimes difficult to answer because on the one hand, we all want to pay a survey firm, assuming that the survey firm is reliable and professional. And we've all heard stories or been the victim, perhaps, of survey firms that do not do a very good job. And so there are other alternatives, such as universities, research centers, or NGOs. And I think that most firms that have done this before can get the job done. But the question is the quality. And when doing deliberative polling, we actually have fairly strict guidelines. For example, one of the very important points that we ask survey firms or research centers to do is to go back and contact people at least 5 to 7 times before giving up. And this is actually something that's difficult for some firms to try to do because they would rather call once, hang up, or go to someone's house, leave if they're not there, instead of trying to go back again and again. And the reason why we stress so much to go back and interview people is because we want to be true to the sample that we have. It may be the case that when the first person we're calling, we may have to try them 7 times in order to get them. But the firm may decide, well, I'll try once and I'll go to the next one. And if you keep going to the next one, you may end up going through your entire sample and not getting much out of it. And so it's very important to us at the center to try very hard to be true to the sample that we select initially. Now, the gender of the interviewers, the training of the interviewers, also very important. Funny stories about how there was one time we did a deliberative poll actually in the area around Stanford, and two of our staff members actually got called to be participants, and little did the interviewers know, these staff members actually could not participate, but once they said they couldn't, the interviewers just hung up on the phone. And so we discovered that some interviewers were not very professional, and we had to let the firm know. And it's very small things like these that really affect how your turnout rate is, and I'm sure many of you have much experience with this and would train the interviewers very carefully. And the next one, I mentioned this already, the number of callbacks that we do, so we'll just move on to the next slide. The actual survey, when we do sample recruitment, we have an interviewer script that we use all the course, then we have a blurb about invitation to deliver polls, including various information such as the location, if there's money involved, how much money we would compensate them for their participation, transportation, and if it's appropriate, prizes and other special events. And we standardize the script, of course, to make sure that all interviewers, will say the same thing.